Valley. I'm Aubrey Kane, your student body president.
And I'm Laurel Noll, your student body vice president. Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please pause for a moment of silence.
Good morning, Spring Valley. I'm Jordan Wilson.
And I'm City Depositor here with your news. We're at the end of the week once again, TGIF. Seniors, we only have 19 more days before we walk across the stage.
Yep, but we only have 13 actual school days left, which reminds me, seniors, if you're in an online class, you have until Monday at 5 to submit all your work. Here's Rebecca with your weekend weather.
Happy Friday, Spring Valley. I'm Rebecca here with your weather for the last weekend before exams. This weekend will be a little wet starting on Saturday with a 30% chance of rain. It only gets worse finishing with a 50% chance of rain on Sunday. This will allow all you seniors to rest before your last high school exam week ever. The temperatures are looking pretty normal for this time of year with a high on Saturday of 86 and a low of 66. On Sunday, the high will be 81 with a low of 57. That's all the weather I have for this weekend. Stay dry, Spring Valley. Back to you, Cindy and Jordan.
Thanks, Becca. Last night's movie night was a huge success. I had a good time. How about you?
I did too, Sid. It's been a while since I've seen Forrest Gump, but it was just a really good time hanging out with everyone in our class.
Yeah, our next scheduled event is our senior cookout, which will be held Tuesday, May 28th at the Lake Carolina Lake House. The cost is only $2 and tickets will be sold next week.
The senior assembly will be Friday the 31st. You have until Wednesday next week to submit your pictures for the slideshow. The cost is $3 for one photo or $5 for three. Turn them in to Ms. Boucher and you can also submit them electronically. And seniors, if you plan to leave right after the assembly, you will need to pick up and fill out a gold slip from the attendance office to make sure you are eligible to leave.
Here's another scenario for our bystander effect investigation.
The reason I didn't stop is because I was in a hurry to go get some food because there's really not a lot of time for us to get food at lunch, so I was on my way and I didn't want to get beat up.
Because I was in a hurry for lunch and I thought someone else was dinner for me.
Yeah, I didn't eat breakfast and I was really hungry and the school didn't really give us like a lot of time and there was a girl and, you know, she looked frightening.
Wow, I guess you guys were hungry, and I can see why no one really stopped to intervene. It's because the girl was doing the intimidating. But did you know that over 29% of domestic violence cases that are reported are men being abused by women?
Yeah, it would have been way different had the roles been switched, but you never know, so consider not being that bystander and help if the situation warrants it. Anyways, y'all, graduation will be here before you know it. If your name or even middle name is hard to pronounce, see Mr. Grantham so he will know how to say it at graduation.
We have a special guest here with us today from the district office, Mr. Ron Huff, to talk about a way Spring Valley can help another cause.
Hello, I'm Ron Huff, the district's Hispanic Family Liaison, and I'd like to speak to you about Help for the Homeless Backpack Roundup, which is a project we're doing. You know, many people just throw out their old book bags at the end of the year, but there's something else you can do with your book bag. Richland 2 and Spring Valley High School has teamed up with Resurrections Ministries to help collect new and used book bags for the homeless in Columbia. For thousands of homeless in town, it is very difficult to maintain a place for their basic possessions like soap, extra clothes, and even pocket change. Often they get assaulted and robbed for what little they have. When backpacks are provided to them, it can make a world of difference. It is a sturdy, useful bag that they can secure very close to their body and hold all that they own in the world. This is a great thing. And the great thing about this is that you can help. I'm here speaking with you, the Spring Valley Vikings, because I know that when it comes to causes for the underprivileged, the Vikings are, they're always the first and ready to help. Starting today, you can donate your book bag at the front of the school with Miss Dee Dee Carpenter. The backpacks will be picked up on the last two Fridays of the school year. Thanks.
Thanks, Mr. Huff. That's all the news for today.